Assalamualaikum dan salam sejahtera. Anda sedang menonton SME bersama saya Najib Arof. Episod hari ini saya nak bercakap tentang platform P2P untuk pembiayaan. Nama syarikat ini adalah Crowdo. Dia syarikat berpangkalan ataupun mempunyai operasi di 3 negara, Malaysia, Indonesia dan juga Singapura. Yang menariknya, syarikat ini yang membezakan dia dengan P2P financing yang lain adalah due diligence prosesnya menggunakan artificial intelligence ataupun AI. Kita ingin mengetahui bagaimanakah teknologi ini disuntik dalam proses perjalanan syarikat tersebut. Kita dengarkan temubual bersama dengan Crowdo.
Leo, thank you so much for joining us. Talking about Crowdo, share with us about Crowdo and when it is established.
Right, okay. Well, thank you very much for having me, Najib. Crowdo was launched in 2013. Mm-hmm. We launched with a vision to create an online marketplace where small, medium-sized enterprises and startups can come to an online platform mm-hmm. to efficiently raise funds. And our role was to basically connect them with a global community of investors. So that was the original premise. Since 2013, we've hit a lot of milestones. We were one of the first operators here in Malaysia to be registered by the Securities Commission for equity crowdfunding. We were one of the first to be licensed in Singapore by the Monetary Authority of Singapore, and also one of the first to be registered with the OJK as well in Indonesia.
Yeah. I want to know about the AI due diligence right. in the Crowdo, right? Maybe you can explain further for the SMEs out there to understand AI due diligence for Crowdo.
Right, okay. So one of the things as a financial technology or fintech startup, what we're trying to do is to help businesses efficiently raise funds. So if you think about the process for equity crowdfunding or for peer-to-peer lending, a business makes an application. The operator, as a licensed operator, we need to do due diligence before it's published on the website for investors to invest in. Now, we have invested a lot of capital and resources to build up a due diligence engine which makes use of the latest technologies in artificial intelligence. So if you think about the traditional way, the reason why SMEs and also startups take 6 to 8 months for the application to get processed is because it's a largely manual and paper-based process. So if you hand in your application today as a business owner, many of the operators and many of the traditional financial institutions are going through the paperwork, assessing it page by page, page by page. Now, the challenge with this is that you could actually use a lot of technology, whether it's artificial intelligence, machine learning processes, to compress a 6 to 8 manual process to a 2-week digital process. So we use the latest algorithms based on artificial intelligence to use a massive amount of data points. So we use close to 3,000 or 4,000 data points to assist with the due diligence process. So we don't have to depend so much on documentation provided solely by the business owner, but also collect data from the web in terms of macroeconomics, microeconomics, the business sector environment, what's happening in your sector, what's happening with other fundraisers in your sector as well.
Yeah, okay. I want to talk about the underserved SMEs because you have such a great data, mm-hmm. I'm sure, through the AI due diligence system, right? How do you see, or how do you view, what's lacking in SMEs or in applying for the loans? What are they lacking?
To be honest, I don't think they're lacking anything. They're business owners. They're great at doing business, but they're often, you know, not great financiers. So either their financial data is unstructured, they don't know how to compile their, you know, financing needs. So this is something, as you know, fintech companies will assist them with. So all of our applications are templated, mm-hmm. They're standardized, they're online, so that a business owner can focus on what he does best, which is focusing on growing and operating his business. And when he's coming up with his financing needs, he has a very efficient and clear path that he needs to follow online. There's this thing called a funding gap. So it's the amount of financing that businesses need as a regular course of their business, as opposed to available capital. Yeah. And you'll see that even in markets like, you know, Singapore, even Malaysia, Indonesia, that gap is close to like 30 or 40 billion US dollars. That means that there's a significant amount of money just not going to the Malaysian businesses. So, of course, the Malaysian businesses, if they have not gotten sufficient access to capital before, they do not know the processes. But we also see this as an opportunity as well, because there's no preconceived notions on how applications need to be done. Yep. So we're hoping that leads, in turn, for them to be more open and willing to adopt new and faster, more efficient digital-driven ways of application and due diligence.
I want to talk about the P2P financings, yep. Because in Malaysia it is relatively still new,
yes.
In Malaysia, right? But how do you foresee for the P2P financing, especially in Southeast Asian market?
Yeah, I think that because of the fundamental issue of the funding gap for small, medium-sized enterprises and also for startups across the region, there's a huge market opportunity. Already where we have gone fully commercial with our peer-to-peer lending products, you know, primarily Indonesia, we see our growth close to 400 or 500% in the few months that we've been operating. So today, I could tell you that if you're a business owner and you come to us, I'll complete your due diligence within 2 weeks' time flat, right? Our funding is typically a few hundred thousand US dollars within a few hours' time, right? If you look at your investors, which are putting in investment, half of that will be local and half of that will be foreign investors, which is great for you because you're not only relying on local domestic investors, you're tapping into a pool of FDI, foreign direct investments, which will be coming from East Asia, Western Europe, and other parts of the world as well.
I want to ask about, because if you see the conventional banks,
yes.
They are normally go for traditional markets of traditional sectors for,
yes.
Businesses, right?
Right.
Should the P2P financing, be it in Malaysia or Southeast Asia, focus on the new markets such as technology, which is in Malaysia, for instance, it's the conventional bank is very slow in giving out loan because of the due diligence system or because some sort of trust issue, like, because they still trust the traditional sector that bring more money and all that.
Yeah.
Should the P2P financing focus on more into new market, such as technology and all that?
I think that what we see in other markets that the initial stage, the clients which go to conventional financial institutions like banks and the companies which come to new financing platforms like ourselves, mm-hmm. is actually not too different. Because at the end of the day, SMEs, startups, they're looking for more efficient, effective ways of financing. Mm-hmm. Right? It is true that at the moment, because of the availability of supply, the banks are a bit more advantaged. You know, if the businesses are willing to spend a long time to access the financing, banking is actually a very good choice. Right? But many of our clients, you know, actually need that cash very quickly for working capital needs or for project financing needs. Mm-hmm. If I look at other markets where we do peer-to-peer lending, we see that about 50% of our clients already have access to banking products, but they'll still come to us because of the speed of distribution.
Itu dia antara perkembangan dan juga apa yang dikongsikan sendiri berkaitan dengan Crowdly ini. Kita bukan saja melihat kepada P2P atau pembiayaan P2P ini kepada usahawan di Malaysia, juga sudah kedengaran untuk P2P bagi sektor perumahan yang masih lagi dikaji mekanisme pelaksanaan dan sebagainya. Dan ini yang digalakkan penyertaan lebih banyak supaya ia mendapatkan jurang pembiayaan, terutamanya di kalangan PKS, sekaligus menyokong pada pembangunan ekonomi Malaysia secara keseluruhan. Sekian sahaja SMI bersama saya, Najib Arof. Assalamualaikum, salam hormat.